Yes, friends. Welcome to the science class. In the last class, we covered the topic named as light, and we started with the exercise questions. We solved up to 7 questions. Now we are going to try to solve the remaining questions up to 11 or up to 12 questions. So that up to 7 questions we have already discussed. Now our 8th question, next question. So that I am not going to write those things. So see your textbook. We are going to discuss those things in the class. So what is the 8th question? Name the type of the mirror used. Name the type of the mirror used. We have to name the type of mirror used. Type of the mirror used in case of first case. In case of headlights of the car. First case, headlight of the car. Which type of mirror we are going to use in a headlight of the car? If you see the headlight of the car, the light is projected inside the car, headlight of that car, it will be at this point. If this is the surface here of the headlight and this will be the covering of that headlight, the light will be projected at this point. If the light is projected at this point, what should we do so that the light should travel in the front side, in the forward direction only? So, as we are traveling in the by the car, the headlight is present in the car, it is going to produce, or it is going to propagate the light in a straight line direction only. So, then for that purpose, is it possible to use a convex mirror here? If the convex mirror is like this, if the light is present here, the light is going to travel in this side. It is going to go in this side, it is going to go in this direction, it is going to go in this direction, as well as it is going to go in this direction. The amount of light which is going in the straight direction is very, very less. For that reason, what we are going to do here is we are going to use the concave mirror. So that concave mirror is going to propagate the light rays which is coming towards it in a straight line direction. In a straight line direction, if you take that concave mirror here, and light is present here, concave mirror here, and light is present here. What will it do? The light ray which is coming towards this concave mirror, like the reflection of always going to travel in the straight line direction. They are going to travel or they are going to propagate in this direction only. So that amount of the light which is traveling in this straight direction will be high, the intensity of the light will be also high, and it is going to cover maximum distance. For that is that in case of headlight of the car, we are going to use what? We are going to use concave mirror. In this case, we are going to use concave mirror. So that light should travel more distance, the intensity of the light should be more, and they always travel in the forward direction. Since it is a converging mirror, the lights are going to travel in the straight direction. In the same manner, they ask a question about where does the light which is placed in a concave mirror in case of headlight of the car. It should be placed on the air only. It should be placed on the principal focus. If you remember, the object, the light ray which are coming from the principal focus are always going to travel parallel to the principal axis. For that reason, the light is going to be placed on the air, that's nothing but principal focus in this case. I hope this is clear. So, we are going to see the second question in the question number 8. That is nothing but B question. What is that? Side or rear view of mirror of vehicle? Side or rear view of mirror of vehicle? Side view or rear view mirror of vehicle? Side view or rear view of mirrors of the vehicle. Which type of mirror we are going to use? If you remember, if you want to see the behind object, how we should see that object in the mirror? It should always be upright and it should cover maximum area there. It should cover maximum area of behind. upright images. It is going to produce upright images and it is going to cover maximum area. If this is the area, the vehicles are present in this area, so that it is going to cover maximum area. The vehicles which are present there, it is going to cover the vehicles which are present here behind, which it is going to cover the vehicles which are present at that point, it is going to cover. For that reason, in case of rear view or side view, here we are going to use what type of mirror? We are going to use convex mirror. We are going to use convex mirror. Why convex mirror? Convex mirror is always going to give a upright image, that is nothing but erected image. So is it possible to see the inverted image in a mirror? We are going to see like this. No, it is not possible. For that reason only, we are going to use what? We are going to use convex mirror in case of rear view or side view of a mirror of a vehicle or automobile. Right? The same way, third question, solar furnace. In this, third question is solar furnace. If you have seen the solar furnace, in the solar furnace, that furnace is going to utilize the solar energy which is coming from the sun. And it is going to convert that solar energy into a heat energy for the purpose of the those things. That nothing but solar furnace is going to convert the solar energy into the heat energy. So what happens? In this case, what we have to do? We have to convert maximum solar energy into the heat energy. So that we are going to acquire minimum amount of solar energy from the sun and we are going to convert maximum amount into a heat energy. Now how it is possible? How it is possible? It is possible when all the light rays which are coming from the sun should converge at a point. Right? All the light rays which are coming from the sun should converge at a point. They should intersect or they should converge or they should merge at a point. If that so, they are going to give high amount of energy, that is nothing but heat energy. If in this case to produce high amount of heat energy, all the light rays which are coming from the sun should converge at a point. If you remember the converging mirror, what is the converging mirror? Converging mirror is nothing but it is a concave mirror. It is a concave mirror. In this case, what we are going to use? We are going to use the concave mirror for the purpose of the solar furnace. If you take the example of the concave mirror, it is like this. The light rays which are coming are going to be parallel to the principal axis. Right? After the reflection, they are going to converge at a point, that is nothing but they are going to converge at the principal focus. If all the light rays at a time are converging at this principal focus, what will happen? Here the amount of heat energy will be maximum. They are going to produce maximum heat energy. For that reason, solar furnace, we are going to use what? We are going to use concave mirror. So that this is the answer for the 8th question. A answer, concave mirror. B, convex mirror. C, concave mirror. I hope this is clear. This is there in your syllabus also. In the advantages or uses of the concave mirror, uses of the convex mirror, uses of the concave lens, uses of the convex lens. As per the norms, due to the corona pandemic, your syllabus is reduced. So because of the reduction in the syllabus, there is no syllabus for the application of the concave mirror as well as convex mirror, as well as there is no syllabus for the, it is not there in your syllabus for the uses of the convex lens as well as concave lens. For that reason, I have skipped that those things. But in the exercise question, this is a question. So it is not going to be there in your examination, since it is not there in your syllabus for this year only due to the corona pandemic. So it is just for understanding purpose I am solving this question. And because of that, I skipped the syllabus for the exercise or for syllabus for the uses of the spherical mirrors and spherical lenses. So it is up to you. This is for the understanding purpose. Right? This is the answer for the what? This is the answer for the 8th question. Now next we are going to see the 9th question. What is that 9th question? See here. Support answer with the reason. Support your answer with the reason. Question is given as 1/2 of a convex lens. 1/2 of a convex verify your answer with an experiment link. Verify your answer with experiment link and explain your observation. Explain your observation. In the 9th question, they are given as a convex lens. They are given convex lens. Convex lens and they are convex lens. They are convex lens. Half of that convex lens is covered with what? It is covered with the black paper. And they ask answer as, is it possible to produce an image by half covered convex lens with a black paper? So, if the yes answer is yes, we have to do it by experiment. If answer is no, we have to say why it is not. So, in this case, if I cover the upper portion here, if I cover the upper portion with the what? With the black paper, I am going to give the object here. I am going to give the object here. And this will be the C and this will be the principal focus of that lens. So, I am just covering the upper portion of the lens. Now in this case, is it possible to produce an image by using the lower portion only? Is it possible? Yes, it is possible. How it is possible? The light rays which are coming from the object are going to go in the all the directions. They are going to go in the all the directions. That means if they are traveling like this, they are going to reflect and they are going to travel parallel to the principal axis. Right? In the same manner, the light ray which are going traveling parallel to the principal axis, right, on reflection they are going to travel on the principal focus. If that is so, here from here the light ray one light ray is going like this, is it possible that the other light ray will be going like this from here? From here. In the same manner, another light ray which is going like this are going to go from here. Right. For the purpose of the ray diagram, we have just only taken the two light rays. But the amount of light rays which are coming from the object will be very, very high. They will be very, very maximum. So to accurately show those ray diagrams, we have just taken only two light rays. But when you check closely, the amount of light rays will be maximum, and they will be in all the directions. So if you take the light rays which are coming from this object, will be from this side, from here, or from here. All the light rays are coming from here are going to converge at a point, converge at this point, so that image is going to form here. Image is going to form here. So our answer is, if the convex lens is covered with a black paper, half part of that convex lens is covered with a black paper, still it is going to produce an image by this lower portion of this side. But intensity of the image, clearance of the image will be less, the brightness of the image will be less due to the less amount of light rays which is going to produce the image only, but the intensity, the clearance will be less. Why is less? The amount of light rays which is going to form the image is less. Because of that, it is going to form the image, but the amount of the intensity of that image will be less. The same manner, if we take the second example also, if we cover this lower portion of this lens, if we cover the lower portion of this lens and we are going to keep the object here, is it possible to produce the image here again? Yes, it is possible. There is nothing but like this, it is going to produce the light ray. Another light ray which is traveling like this is again going to merge at a point. Another light ray which is traveling here is going to merge at a point. So that if they are merging at a point, if they are intersecting at a point, they are going to produce again. The intensity of the image will be less, but they are going to produce an image. Right? So, in this case, that is nothing but 9th question. One half of the convex lens is covered with a black paper. Is it possible that it is going to produce the image? Yes, it is possible to produce the image. And observation is that the image will be is not clear. That nothing but it will be clear image, but the brightness or the intensity of the image will be less due to the less light rays which are going to form that image. So I hope this is clear. How is this light are coming? If I take the light one which is passing through the principal focus, another light which is traveling parallel to the principal axis, in between these two light rays, there will be a high amount of light rays which are
Are you
centralized ray diagram for the purpose of the calculating the size, nature, and position of the image. So if you check here, the image is forming in between C and L. So that the image distance should be more than 10 cm and it should be less than 20 cm. The size of the image is less than the size of the object. That is nothing but the size of the object should be less than 5 cm, as well as the magnification should be less than 1 and it will be negative. So we should find out our answers like this only. Now next we are going to calculate all those things. Before calculating all those things, what we have to do here, we have to take the Cartesian sign conversation. Here we have to take the Cartesian sign conversation so that height of the object by sign, Cartesian sign conversation, it will be plus 1 because object is always upright. Object is always will be upright. If you apply the Cartesian sign conversation here, object is upright for that reason. X equal to how much? It will be positive. In the second manner, object distance, if you take the object which is kept at the left hand side, which is kept at the left hand side by the Cartesian sign conversation, object distance is always negative. So then it will be minus 25 cm. This is on the left hand side. We are going to calculate the object distance from this point to this point. If it is coming at the left hand side, it will be minus. The focal length of the lens. If you see the problem statement, the problem in the problem statement, they are given as the converging lens. If they are given as the converging lens, that is nothing but convex lens. The focal length of the convex lens is always positive, so that it will be plus 10 cm. It will be plus 10 cm. So that now we are going to find each answer one by one. So what we have to find out first, we have to find out V, so that we know that formula for the focal length or lens formula, that is nothing but 1 by F equal to 1 by V minus 1 by U. 1 by V minus 1 by U. So that what is the value of F, which is given in the problem statement, that is nothing but 10 equal to 1 divided by V minus 1 divided by U. What is the value of U? That is minus 25 U. 1 by 10 equal to 1 by V minus into minus it will be plus, that will be equal to 1 divided by 25 U. Right? So then we have to take down value one side, down value one side, therefore 1 by V equal to 1 by 10 remains there only, plus in this side when it comes to the LHS side, it will become minus. So 1 divided by minus 25 U, minus 1 divided by 25 U. So 1 by V equal to, we are going to find out the LCM or we are going to do the cross multiplication. So here I am going to do the cross multiplication, that is nothing but 25 times 25 U minus 10 times 10 divided by 25 times how much is equal to 215. It is equal to 215. So that 25 minus 10 is equal to how much? It is equal to 15. 1 by V equal to 15, 4 divided by 15. Therefore 5 is the 5 or 50 is the, that equal to how much? That is equal to, therefore V equal to how much? That is equal to 50 by 3 cm. V equal to 50 by 3 cm and the value of V is positive, so that our answer is right. Because of that our answer is right. So it can be written as, it can be written as 3 1 the 3 16 the 48 mm to, again it will be 6, that is nothing but 16.67 cm. V equal to how much? It is equal to 16.667 cm. If you check the ray diagram, by the ray diagram, the value of those things that should be less than 20 cm, it should be more than 10 cm. When you check the value, the range is, it is more than 10 cm and it is less than 20 cm, so that our answer is right. And image is forming on the right hand side, that means the value should of the value of the image distance should be positive. And it is positive. So our answer is right. We have find out the image here. Next, what we have to find out? We have to find out the magnification. So what is the value? What is the formula for the magnification? Magnification formula is nothing but M equal to V by U. n equal to what is the v, v value here? If we take the v value as fraction, that is nothing but 50 by 3. That is nothing but 50 by 3 divided by what is the value of u, which is given in the problem statement, that is nothing but 25 u. That is nothing but minus 25 u. 25 1 down, 25 2 down. Plus divided by minus equal to how much? It will be minus 1 d. So they are then equal to minus 2 divided by 3. M equal to minus 2 divided by 3. If you want to put their values in decimal, minus 2 by 3 is equal to how much? It is equal to 0.66. Minus 0.66. So the magnification of that image is nothing but how much? It is minus 0.66. If the magnification is negative, what it means? The image is inverted by the ray diagram. How image is there? Image is inverted only. If the magnification is less than 1, what it means? The image size will be smaller than the size of the object. So if you check the value here, it is less than 1, so that you can say that the size of the image will be smaller than the size of the object. So next we have to find out the size of the image. So we have another formula, that is nothing but m equal to h dash divided by. Yes, to find out the size of the image. So, what is the value of m? That is nothing but minus 2 by 3. I am going to take the fraction here. That equal to, what is the value of h dash here? We don't know, so I am going to write it as it is. H dash. Now, what is the value of h? Which is given in the problem statement, that is given as plus 5 cm. That is equal to plus 5. Right? So, therefore, h dash equal to 1, it is equal to minus 2 by 3 into 5. Minus 2 by 3 into 5. That is equal to how much? H dash equal to 10 minus 10 divided by 3, which can be written in the decimal as minus 3.33 centimeters. It can be written as minus 3.33 centimeters. So the size of the image is equal to how much? Is equal to minus 3.33 centimeters. So at last what we have to do? We have tried everything so that position of the image, so that position of the image is, position of the image is that from 16.66 centimeters, and size of the image is 3.33 centimeters. And size of the image is 3.33 centimeters. And nature, this is inverted one. And nature is inverted one. It is real image, smaller in size. Inverted image, real image, and it is smaller in size. So that this is the completion of your 10th question. After completing this question, you have to draw the ray diagram and you have to mention the focal length, as well as you have to mention the distance of the object, size of the object, size of the image, distance of the image by finding the, by calculating those things. So your 10th problem is over. And in the next class we are going to discuss the remaining portion which are given in your textbook as exercise. So try to solve the 11th question in your home. Take it as homework. Take it as homework. So it is easy one. Here in case of this, they are given the concept that it is easy one. We are going to find out easily. So try to solve that.